At the beginning of The Sweetness of Water, we meet Prentice and Landry, two brothers who were recently freed by their owner, and they are deciding what steps they want to take next in their lives. And they end up on the land of a man named George Walker, whose son recently died in the war, and he sort of takes them in as a replacement surrogate children of his own in a way, and pays them a fair wage. And the town of Old Ox will turn against him for giving them a fair wage, and it will lead to repercussions and consequences that he could never really see coming. Sure. I think as a writer of historical fiction, it's always important to find material that hasn't really been covered in a way. And I always loved historical fiction, especially about the Civil War, whether it be Cold Mountain, The Known World, even Gone with the Wind, politics aside. And I wanted to find a story that I could tell, that I could share with people from that time period. And I found that I had never read a book about what these freed men and women went through right after they, were let go. So I decided to sort of dig into that and the history of that, and I found that this is a story that I could tell, a story that I feel like people also needed to hear. From what I can imagine, a shocking moment. I mean, I don't care who you are. Let's say you are a steel worker and you've worked in, in a mine or wherever you are for 50 years, and you're suddenly let go. What do you do? And this is like that times 100. You've been in bondage for your whole life. Your routine has been set by your master every single day. And suddenly, you know, that gate swings open and they say, you're free to do as you wish. You know, that's been ordered. And I just had no idea what that would look like. I couldn't even imagine. So I decided, well, it's your job as a novelist to try to imagine that and take that on. And it was a big responsibility, and I did my best to do justice to all those men and women who were emancipated. I think part of what I was trying to do with the novel is, render it true to history. I don't ever want somebody to read the novel and feel like I lost track of the time period and how it was supposed to feel on some level. But at the same time, I was trying to emphasize that what these characters are going through are the same issues that Black Americans are going through today. You know, and that women are going through today when it comes to Isabel, George's wife in the novel. So it was in many ways a contemporary novel, but again, veiled behind this idea of history. But I don't think that makes it anachronistic or wrong. It's just a very interesting way to connect the past to the present and show that reader that connection and how far we've come, but how much progress we still have to make. Thank you.